Today I'm going to be reacting to my old art school art. This is part two of a two-part video. If you haven't watched the first one already, check it out over here. My name is Janet. I'm an ex-Disney artist turned independent creator. I quit my job in order to go full-time into my online art business. I wanted to react to some of my old art school art to show you that everyone starts somewhere. Since this is part two, I'm going to be showing some of the more advanced stuff that I did later on in college. Before we get started, make sure to like the video, jingle all my bells and buttons for new videos every Monday, Wednesdays, and Fridays. For those of you who don't know, I went to Art Center College of Design for art school in Pasadena, California. I majored in illustration with a focus in entertainment arts, which is why I eventually worked for DreamWorks and Disney once I graduated as a storyboard artist. But before then, I actually thought I was going to be a designer. I thought I was going to be a visual artist, perhaps a character designer or a background artist. So you're going to see a whole lot of viz dev work. I have a whole separate viz dev portfolio that I created before I switched over to storyboarding, and then I have my storyboarding portfolio. Let's get started. First up, this was done in my style class. They really try to beat the individuality out of you when you are trying to pursue animation, I guess. This class in particular is to train you to be able to draw and teach yourself to draw in any style that they throw at you. For this one, the style was 101 Dalmatians. This was actually done traditionally. I scanned the drawing in and then painted on top of it. This style is to emulate the style of Lane Smith, a children's book illustrator. So it's a very unique, fun style, and we had to illustrate a scene from Alice in Wonderland. I think a lot of people don't understand how difficult illustrating in a style that is suitable for children's books truly is. And I can't talk about Art Center without talking about Charlie Harper, because Art Center is also known for its graphic design department. Everyone loves Charlie Harper, and we had to emulate that style. We had to create something like a travel poster. There is a whole lot of thought that goes into these kinds of designs, more than you'd think. I dare everyone to try it. It's very difficult because it is more about shape design and color design and graphic design than anything else. This is basically the start of my VizDev portfolio. I basically created designs for the book, The Phantom Tollbooth, another character from the Phantom Tollbooth book. I created these designs soon after my internship. I interned at an advertising post-production company at Blind, run by Chris Doe, who runs The Future here on YouTube. He was a great mentor to me, and I fell in love with graphic design and I incorporated it into my personal design. This was supposed to be the main character of the Phantom Tollbooth. I made him wear PJs and I put the PlayStation controller buttons on his shirt because I think he was supposed to be a little bit like a petulant child who just loved video games and didn't want any kind of responsibility or something like that. These are some prop designs that I designed for the Phantom Tollbooth. Prop designs aren't the most interesting things to look at. This is the bottle that keeps the awful din locked away. This is the scene that I designed with all the props together, and I designed this really neat car. One of the background paintings and background designs that I had done. I think this was the office of one of the characters in the Phantom Tollbooth. Another background painting that I did early on. I really like the designs in this painting. The villains off on the right side, I think they're so ridiculous looking. I don't know what I was thinking, but like, I really love them. And the frog design is just so appealing. These are character designs that I had done. I basically wrote a story and designed the characters for that story. I imagined a goth bellhop running the hotel. I thought this design was really fun. This is the cabaret singer of the hotel. It's not the best character design by any means. For some reason, I had a whole like goth theme to this class. I don't remember what this character was for. Oh, funny story about this. The teacher wanted us to create our own reference photos for all of the character designs. A lot of people didn't listen to him. I didn't either. So I came to class and I showed him my designs and he was like, where are your reference photos? And I didn't have any, but I did have my camera on me at the time. So I don't like being shamed. I'm gonna go take them right now. I need some props, I need some costumes, and I need a model. I went to the school cafeteria, I picked the dude and was like, hey you, do you want a model for me? He was like, okay. I ran down to the prop room, grabbed some costumes, grabbed some props, sat him down on like the couch outside the school library. I was like, do these weird poses for me. Took pictures of a complete stranger and was like, cool, thank you. Ran back to class, started working on this design. The teacher comes back around, is surprised to see that I suddenly have reference photos, was very amused, asked me where I got them. I just pulled some guy outside to do it. He just like quietly nodded and all he said was, you're going to make someone a whole lot of money one day. He wasn't wrong. So this one, I wanted to design a demon devil character at the time. These were some backgrounds and designs I had made during my internship. I am still very proud of them. I worked really hard at this internship. I learned probably more in those 6 months that I was there than I did it probably in any of the years that I had at Art Center. A car design that I designed for the same internship story thing. The script had a carousel and I designed a carousel. Some prop designs for the same story. These are the characters in the story. I had to emulate this other artist's style from before. The story has like a before and after version of these characters. So these are the before and this is the after. Near the end of my Art Center career, I switched completely over to storyboarding. I realized that is exactly what I want to do because I wanted to direct one day. Specifically, I wanted to direct my own stuff. I would write and board out my own little short film, I guess. This is the portfolio that I had submitted to a lot of job openings. It got me a test at DreamWorks at the time. And this was like about a year or so before I graduated. If I had gotten lucky at the time and gotten hired, I probably wouldn't have graduated and I would have just started working. I ended up not getting the job, so I just finished school. Basic story is, there's this old Victorian house. These two kids go to this house who they hear has a cure for this incurable disease. The big brother wants to get a cure for her. They knock on this door. It's really scary. The door opens, suspense, and reveal of the villain. The villain invites them in. I had a lot of fun designing the interior, like cabinet of curiosities type space. So they approach the villain. The villain offers them a cure in exchange for their signature. They sign it. Suddenly, she is magically cured. The villain starts transforming into a monster. He takes his sister away. The boy chases him. Reveal this really crazy interior factory looking space that I had designed. A really dynamic pan. The boy gets determined to fight for or get his sister back. End scene. I did some basic turnarounds of the characters. They're not good turnarounds. Designed for the villain. I did some basic SketchUp modeling of each of the rooms to make it easier on me to board. This was a complete other board that I had boarded. The basic premise is aliens visit this ancient civilization and they are looking for something. So this girl is tasked at helping them find this object. Pan down to reveal the characters. The girl is getting into this canoe boat thing. She paddles out. They're scared for her. The alien gives her one of their boots. Funny moment with the cute creature. She paddles out and there is this huge ancient shark-esque creature in the water. She dives down, manages to not alert the shark. She finds the object that she's looking for. She grabs it, but she pricks her hand. Now there's blood in the water and the shark has noticed her. She has to escape and propel herself out of the water away from harm. Before she can even recover, the object is stolen from her. She looks up and there's this menacing spaceship thing. Reveal that one of the alien has betrayed them and is actually the villain of the story. A little bit of a villain monologue, and then suddenly the ship shakes, the ship is hit by some kind of magical ancient beam. Chief of the ancient civilization has come to the rescue to save his city from doom. These are some of the character designs that I designed for the story. I made a SketchUp model of the room to make it easier for me to board. These are some of the designs for the other characters and a scene that didn't end up making it into the boards. And this is another animatic that I had done. I had done all the voices and the sound effects, kind of just like a gangster mob triad storyboard. The main mob boss is this little girl and she's trying to steal some weird object. She goes into this store and has a showdown with this old granny who turns out to be not so easy to steal from. This is one of a three-part board that I had done for my graduation board portfolio, and I created these characters. It was a mad dash to the finish. I was really tired by the end of it. I basically did the voices and I got Vincent to do the voices for, I think, all the male characters. My boarding ability got better and better as time went on. Even looking at this now, there are so many things that I wish I had done better. And I am so much better at storyboarding and drawing now, and at shot language too. It's kind of neat to revisit all the stuff that I did back in college and to remember how hard I genuinely tried on some of this and just being like, oh, yeah. I was not ready yet because some of these drawings are wonky. To be honest, it's a little bit cringe for me to see all of this, but you know, at the end of the day, it's what I did in my student days. If you want to learn how to use social media to grow your online business, check out my free guide, 8 Steps to Launch Your Online Store. Head over to honeyabsinthe.com to help support this channel by buying some merch. Check out these other videos next if you want to see more of my drawing videos. If you like the video, jingle all my bells and buttons for more art and entrepreneurship type videos, and don't forget to dare to dream.